Silver Greyscale here, getting back to more Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. So we're following this path from Gary's room in the Nosferatu lair. I take a swig of water because hydration is important. We have a ladder we can take here. And you might be wondering, where the heck are we? Well, if I open this door, we come out in the mausoleum. So yeah, that path will now work back and forth to and from the Warrens. So yeah, we don't have to go through the sewers anymore. We can just head straight to the graveyard and to the mausoleum, and then take the secret passage. And that's of course something that is pretty well known about the Nosferatu in VTM lore. Is that they always have some kind of secret passage to get to and from their base. And they're usually also wandering the my brain, please. They're also wandering the sewers quite a bit. Mostly because, well, you know, we can more or less pass as a human. They can't. Oh, did someone just go behind here? Oh, that is wonderful. That is so good. It's very kind of that man to walk alone into an alleyway. Also, one thing I saw in a video not too long ago, I think it was titled like The Atmosphere of Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, which I wholly agree with. I mean, we can see Los Angeles from here. Like, we can see the main part of the city from here, which is definitely adding to the feeling of like immersion.
Evening. Here. And thanks again for your help earlier. And remember what I told you about LaCroix. You're good, kid. He doesn't deserve you.
And yeah, for doing what we did, we get a gift from him. We get the Pearl of Dubai. This gives us a boost to our charisma. So we now have a second dot in our charisma, which have added up to our persuasion bonus. Alright, so before we take the cab and head downtown, because, well, we're gonna need to look at our computer in our haven, we're gonna use the key that we got to get in here. So, this essentially is Tawny's apartment building. Nine lives. Celebrity Ash Rivers walks away from deadly crush. So yeah, we're gonna look at a few of those other places as well. But essentially, here we are. Yeah, there's essentially like lights everywhere. Okay, I don't like. Okay, where is she headed now? So we're gonna trance him. And yeah, we failed because we got spotted on our way out to. God damn it. Computer's here. There we go. Now we need to get out. I'm gonna make a save here. I thought for a second that he fucking saw me. And he saw me, of course he did. And yeah, he's holding a gun, by the way, so.
He's in town to speak to his peers about his recent dig in Turkey and coordinate examination of the artifacts found at the Incarn site. Hey, who's there?
Oh boy. Oh boy, the fact that we actually succeeded is something. But yeah, I have always just run through that without, you know, really caring. I've always done the no target thing. So, before we head back to downtown to check our haven and all that, I do want to deal with a side quest here. Because we have a man here, and this man is pretty interesting.
Right back at you.
So, the song playing at this place is one of my all-time favorite songs. It is by this band, Tiamat, and the song is named Cain.
I don't think so.
So, the person we want to speak to is this guy.
I just might. The sun's gone down. Never mind. Why don't you ask everyone else in the world? They'd know. Never mind. Me neither. What's the catch? To say yes would be an understatement. What do you care anyway? I could just do it. Just walk out of here and into a legend. Maybe I live, maybe I don't. What's the difference? You didn't see them? Hunters in front, back, inside my club. I try to leave, they'll move on me. So I had to ask myself, if I go out there, am I prepared to die? How many could I take out before the killing stroke, huh? Two? Three? I could just walk out there, right now, blaze of glory, the end. And you know what? Knowing that, it doesn't bother me. And I guess the only reason I haven't walked out yet is because I'm trying to figure out why it doesn't bother me. Now, did Isaac send you? What the hell, then, would be your motivation to help me? And what do you propose we do?
So yeah, we have two choices here. We can either escort him out through the sewers, but we might have to fight the hunters. It's the riskier option, but you won't lose humanity for it. However, the easiest thing to do, which is going to cost you a point of humanity, is to switch his clothes for someone in the club that looks like him. That's the one I recommend, and it's a lot easier than having to fight hunters. I don't want to fight hunters currently.
Did you get that idea from a sitcom? Whatever. Look around the club, maybe you'll get lucky.
So yeah, that is Ash Rivers, the actor who is supposed to be dead. And yeah, we have a man here who looks just like him.
Do I know you?
Zombie and zombie Montessori? I'm telling you, any day, boom, I'm dead.
Cash? What do I have to do? Sure, I can do that. I thought you were going to make me eat a tarantula or stick a worm up my nose.
So yeah, he is now going to go to the toilets, and we tell Ash to go to the men's bathroom.
I hope they get these hunters from the temp agency, because all the pro's going to do is have a laugh. If it works, I'm out of this city. Here, token of my thanks.
Get some money, as we helped him evade hunters. We get some XP for that. However, we lose humanity because, well, this dude is gonna die. Or rather, fake Ash is gonna die. We can see here that he's dead, and the hunters have up and left. And if you head upstairs, you can see that Ash is gone. So, he did exactly what he said he would do. He said he would get the hell out of the city, and he did. I would personally not recommend fighting hunters. Not when we're definitely not ready for it. Because vampire hunters are, well, really damn powerful. And another place that we want to look at is in here. Club Vesuvius. Is yet another interesting club. And we have someone who we actually recognize over here.
Look what just walked in. I can't imagine you'd get much of a rise out of Vesuvius, being what you are. Maybe I'll have more luck with you. I think we should get to know each other a little better upstairs, where we can be ourselves. Come up to my room. Just 14 little steps. I'll make it worth it. Believe me.
So yeah, we're gonna follow Venus here. Or, well, I don't think her name was Venus, but anyway. This lady here owns this place, which is why this is an Elysium. And you should recognize this lady, because she was at our trial.
Isn't this better? You and me alone, for just a little while. Away from jihad and the nonsense and the dangers, just the two of us. I don't want to spoil the moment, but there's a reason I needed to speak to you alone. Oh yes, what gave me away?
And yeah, she's a Torridor.
How absolutely intoxicating for you to notice. I'm beginning to think bringing you up here was an even better idea than I thought. The reason I asked you up here is because I and the rest of the Hollywood kindred have been under surveillance lately by hunters. I didn't want you to say anything that might draw attention. Think nothing of it. I'm Velvet. Velour. Call me Velvet. It's been months since I've seen anyone new in here. I was starting to take it personally. And who should finally walk in but a real celebrity? I've heard a lot about you. So, wouldn't you like to know about me? I'm like a book. All you have to do is run your finger down my spine and crack me open to see what I'm about.
You're very subtle, lady. You are as subtle as a freight train. But yeah, Velvet Velora here was at our court procedure. Shortly after we got embraced, she was the woman who blew a kiss to Max Strauss, who just shrugged it off.
Hunters. Yes. They've been staking out Hollywood for several weeks. They've been in Ash's club, mine, a few others. I think they're whittling down their list of suspects. I'm a bit nervous. Until recently, I had one right under my nose. For a few weeks, one of them was working here at Vesuvius, keeping an eye on the clientele. I found a weapon in her locker and I fired her. She's still in Hollywood watching my club. And me. I've had to adjust a lot to this existence. And I've accepted that I may have to do just that. But I'm a suspect, and if she ends up dead and I'm seen, they'll either kill me or chase me into obscurity, where I'll wither and die. Would you? I think it might be a little much to ask. You'd really be willing to do this for me? I won't lie. It's gonna be dangerous. But if you got rid of her, I'd be grateful. Very, very grateful. She works over at the sin bin now. Her hair's blonde. On top. Broken heart tattoo on the small of her back. Dances under the name Chastity. As if that wasn't a dead giveaway. I want you to understand. I don't want any innocents killed on my account. So if there are other dancers or patrons around, you'll have to lure them away from her. Do it as quietly as you can. No witnesses, please. And be careful using disciplines around the hunter.
So, what she says about being careful to not use disciplines around the hunter is, kind of sort of false. You can still use blood buff, but you can't use, like, let's say, aspects or trance or anything like that. But essentially, we did see the name Chastity. And yeah, Velvet, just like many other NPCs, have have quests for us. Now, if I recall correctly, we need to hack into the peep show here. And 1 second, just have to check my... phone, because I see I have a few notifications. Alright, so what we want to do is we want to lock down all of these. It will cause this man to be very, very frustrated. As you can see. And he will essentially leave. So once that's done, we can open up this door here. Okay, this man is still dancing or watching. And I would say his way would be to... feed on him once the window goes down. We saw a woman kick this door, which didn't really do much. I am... forgetting what it is we need to do to... open up there. 'Cause last time I did this quest on my own, I basically... more or less, like, forced her out with, like, disciplines and whatnot. Yeah, that's the woman we need. But in order to get in there, it's going to be really tough. I don't care that we lost humanity. However, essentially, when that's done, be ready to save. Because, yeah. She goes straight for the blade. Now, it is not exactly what Velvet might have wanted from us. But that's also the beauty of this game. You beat these quests however the heck you want to beat them.
Look who's back. Couldn't stay away, could you? I asked you not to kill anyone else. You may be able to wash that blood off your hands easily, but my conscience will soak in it. Have you already forgotten your humanity? Because I haven't. It was a tragedy. Loss of life is a tragedy, not an accident. Mingle. Sightsee. Poor, poor David Hatter.
And yeah, here we have the second quest she has. Of course, like the easiest way to more or less like make sure that the dude who is just like in the peep show stuff is to, of course, deal with the money so that he can't get more money. But it's also something that takes a long time. I personally prefer just killing the guy. Sure, poor Velvet doesn't like it, but still.
David Hatter's an aspiring screenwriter and hotel manager. He comes in more often than he would admit. Several years now. Poor dear just can't get a break. I overheard him talking about his new screenplay with one of my girls. It was about secret societies and creatures that found themselves dealing with inner beasts and persecution by elder monsters. Sound reminiscent of something to you?
He's writing a movie about the Bush administration. Yes. But no, he is writing about Kindred.
Yes. The details of his story were too insightful to be coincidental. I think someone's working with David. A Kindred who doesn't realize the consequences of their actions. Do you know what the penalty for revealing ourselves to Kine is? Death. I'm afraid poor David's big break. The screenplay he's worked so hard on must be destroyed, and his less than silent partner must be executed. I know David too well. I'm very fond of David, and I'm too close to do what needs to be done. No! I don't think Hatter knows his collaborator is Kindred. You'll have to take David's screenplay. And somehow, you'll have to coax the name of his source out of him. Once you've found out who, kill the traitor. But do not touch David. David works at the Lucky Star Motel. He's very passionate about his writing. He loves to talk about his craft. I'm sure he'll talk about his screenplay. It may take some persuasion to get him to give up his collaborator's name, however. After this is over, I promise, you'll have my complete attention.
So yeah, if you decided to act in the best interest of the Masquerade and kill David when he started talking to you about what he's writing, Velvet is not going to be happy about that because, well, like she says, she's too fond of him. So essentially, what we need to do is make sure that we don't kill David. We can kill the traitor and we can do all of that, but like, we are not allowed to kill him. But since I killed him on my own playthrough, Velvet was not too happy with me when I told her about that and basically told me to, in no certain terms, piss off.
Night eating you? A good writer always does in this town. Hey, you in the business? Because, man, I got tons of ideas for movies. In fact, I should give you one of my completed screenplays. This one's still a work in progress. You do? Man, that's fantastic! I can give you my screenplay if you promise to keep it safe. I really can't talk about it. He likes his privacy. Well, I don't know. I mean, you know how much sending manuscripts to agents costs? Night eating you?
So, I really can't yeah, we can't pay him, but we can attempt to threaten him.
His name? He goes by Julius. That's all I know. I'm supposed to meet him tonight. He's just a weird beach bum under the Santa Monica Pier. Man, why are you doing this to me?
And we found who collaborates with him. Julius. Poor David, he doesn't know that Julius is a kindred. Julius, why do you do this to us? So yeah, back to Santa Monica we go. And we're gonna head to the beach to speak to Julius.
It's a nice night out, huh?
But yeah, essentially, in terms of, like, side quest stuff, this is the last thing we need to do that takes us here to Santa Monica. Well, more or less. There is a series of side quests that we're getting later that puts us back here, but other than that, the only time you will be forced to come back here is because of main story stuff later. And we can see that everyone else but this guy is gone.
What do you want? No. Please, I didn't mean to understand what I am. I didn't know. I'm so sorry. Please, I'll never do it again. No. Oh, God.
How do you want it? Decapitation? Barbecue? Cobain special?
Please, find your heart. Please, find your heart. Oh God. No.
There we go. We even got the manuscript, so humanity versus the vampire lords, huh?
Who's back? That's Miss Valor to you. Mm-hmm. Oh, I suppose I should just tear it up. But I can't. I can't rip up the product of that man's soul. Here, would you tear it up for me? Thanks. Are they? I mean, did you? It must have been difficult. But take some comfort in knowing if you hadn't, someone else would have had to. I do appreciate your help. A lot. I'm willing to ignore the incredible lengths you've gone to be an asshole. I'm sorry. I'd rather revel in the present than dwell on the past. I'm a dancer. It is now. Look who's... Yes.
Yeah, with that... We've done all of... Velvet's quests. Now we also protected the Masquerade. Next time, we're going to be taking a cab, somewhere in that direction, back to downtown LA to go to our haven and... Well, we're going to check our email for the result of this quest. We're going to see if we've gotten the stuff there. But before that, we are going to tell Imalia that we have done what she asked us to do. I will see you all next time. Goodbye.